Hello, in this video, I'll show you how and why I updated the code for my Nebula star projector lights to go from using light components to number components. Currently, on my bench, I've got the unit from the lounge. I've also printed out a target with a grid on so we can see the movement a little bit better. Let's zoom in on that target. On my desktop, I've got the original code, and I've also got the controls for this Nebula light. First of all, let's turn on the laser. We'll also turn the light off on my desk so we can see it a little bit better. And I'm going to turn on the motor. And if you remember, both of these are lights. So if we go to the laser itself, I'll make that just a tad brighter. As you can see, that didn't make that much difference. And if we go to the motor control, it's currently set at 47%. As you can just about see, that dot there, you can see it's just barely creeping across the grid. So that's in the center of that grid there, and it's just hitting that crosshair. But that's at 47%. If I go any lower than about 45, that's completely stopped. So that's no good. So let me show you what I did. Now, I've already written this code. You'll find it on my GitHub page. It's called Updated Code YAML. First of all, I'm going to take out these. I'm just going to comment those out for the time being. Into here, let's add some space. I added two sliders to replace these lights here. We've got the code for the sliders or number component from my GitHub page. And also, we're going to add some more code here. We need to add our two servo components, which are essentially replacing the two light components in terms of the PWM output. And I found these give a much better PWM signal with a little bit more control than a light, so we can control our laser and our motor much better. And let's go back up. Let's talk about these numbers. The slider itself uses the substitution, same as the light here. And these range from 0 to 100%. And the automation for both of these sliders, they're pretty much the same. They just control different servos, which is this part here. So we've got servo right main laser that I've called it, and servo right main motor. And those are these two here. So that's main laser and main motor. And the whole thing is controlled by this set action automation. And this automation will turn on the servo output as long as the slider value, X, remember X is the internal value for the component that it's connected to, is greater than or equal to 1. If this condition is true, then it's going to do this. It's going to write to the servo with the ID of laser, which is this one here, with a level. Now, a level for a servo is its position. Now, a servo can be from -1 through 0 to +1. And that gives you your full range of approximately 180 degrees. And the way servos work is they use a PWM signal from a very thin to a very wide pulse width. So what this automation does, it takes the value from 0 to 100, which is here, which is the X. And because the servo needs to be between -1 and 1, I'm multiplying it by 100. Now that's the same as dividing it by 100. But obviously, if that's 0, this will be 0, because anything times 0 is 0. If this is 100, then this will be 1. So when the slider is at 1, we'll times that by 1/100th, and that's essentially our servo position of 0. So this level here will be from 0 to 100 on the slider, times it by 1/100th. So this will be 1/100th all the way to 1. Now, one thing we can't do with a servo is give it the same value twice. Obviously, if the servo's in a position, the software knows that it's in that position. So if I set my slider, say 30 on here, if I turn it off, then turn it back on again, it's going to send 30 back to this level. Now, if the level hasn't changed, it's not going to attempt to move the servo. So a little workaround is I've added a very small offset. A random float will give a random value every time it's called between 0.0, 0.1, 0.5, all the way up to 1.0. And again, I'm timesing that by 1/100th. So that's going to be obviously a very small number. So every time I set my slider to say 30, it's going to be 0.3 plus a random, very small number. And this is going to be something like 0.3. I guess a small offset, so the value is different every time and the servo won't ignore it. Like I say, if you give it the same value twice, it won't output a PWM signal. And we want this to output a PWM signal every time it's turned on. And then if this is less than 1, so if this condition is not true, else turn off the output. So when you set the slider, it will turn on the output and set the level for the servo component. which is this thing here. When you turn it off, if it's zero, it's going to turn off the output completely. In this instance, the laser PWM. I say exactly the same for the motor, except we're controlling the main motor servo and the motor PWM instead. One little change I did make as well is that PWM frequency for the motor output, I changed from 100 down to just 8. And you'll see in a second, that works quite nicely. We'll save that and we'll hit install. Okay, that's done. We should see some changes here. Sometimes these lights disappear and are replaced by numbers. Let's see if we're going to be lucky here. So there you go. It's got rid of the lights and replaced them with our two sliders, which is quite nice. Right, back to the demo then. So first of all, we're going to turn the laser on. I'm going to put that nice and low at 20%. We can see now we've got all the way up to maximum, which will blow up my camera. Then because of the way the diode in the laser works, it's not quite linear. So we'll get quite a lot of brightness change at the bottom end. And then as we go up, it's almost an exponential curve. But as you can see, we do get quite a range. So I'm going to put that down to about 20%. Now the motor, as you can see, none of these dots are moving because the motor's at zero. If I put that to maximum speed, it's pretty much the same speed as it was before. And we do have a bit more granular control now. So if I put it down to 28%, we can see that's nice and slow, but we can also go down to 1%. And of course, this 1% makes a lot more sense than 48% that we had running on the lights. And again, we can see, if we look at that dot there, we can see that just creeping ever so slowly into the middle of that square and out again on the top right corner. So there you go, nice and slow, all the way up to maximum speed. And if we look down here, you can see what I was talking about earlier on. So the Nebula motor number, which is here, is currently at 100%, and the servo target is 1.0. If I change this to 51%, we see that the number is at 51%, but the servo target is 0.51 plus that random at the end. If I take it down to, say, 50 and put it back up again, we've now got a different random number so that the servo knows that it should go into a different position, even though I've set it back to 51%. And like I say, normally the output wouldn't change because I basically told the servo to go to the same position. And of course, if I turn it down to zero, you'll see that the number is zero. The servo again has reached its target, but more importantly, it's turned off the PWM output. So there you go. That works. Well, I hope this video was helpful for your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.
Okay, I love you. Bye-bye.